you ever watch videos, people are like, so do I look here? Hey, people do that, and I just did it.
AquaMethod Podcast. Nonconformist, positive nonsense. AquaMethod Podcast.
What's going on, y'all? It's your boy GP, and you're rocking with me on the Aqua Method Podcast. As always, you can find me on Twitter, Grasshopper GP, spelled normally. Instagram, Grasshopper GP, spelled normally. Send me an email at grasshoppergp@yahoo.com for any types of sponsorships, any types of advertisements, or if you just have something nice to say about the podcast, I really appreciate it. Thank you to all the listens, the views, the likes, the retweets, all that good stuff, all the favorites, everything, all the shares. Just hit that subscribe button, hit that like button on the YouTube page. I really appreciate it. The YouTube page, by the way, is Grasshopper GP Official. That's Grasshopper GP with three S's and Grasshopper, because when I made the account, I couldn't spell. Grasshopper GP Official, three S's. It's a YouTube account. Today, I am joined by two very special ladies, two very lovely ladies. Miss Michelle, Miss Bridget, how are y'all ladies doing today?
Good. Doing pretty good.
Doing all right?
How about you?
I'm doing wonderful. Because I'm always, my day is always better when I'm joined by pretty women.
Oh, you know, well,
so I must be doing all right.
Yeah.
Well, let me tell you how I know these two fine young ladies. Me and Michelle went to high school together.
Right.
Palmville High School, class of 2006.
That's a long time ago now.
So long ago. So, are you going to the 10-year reunion?
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah. Did you get any emails, anything from them?
No, not yet.
Okay, because you know who's running it, right?
I assume it's got to be like Elise or something.
You would think that, huh?
Right.
It's Courtney.
Oh,
Courtney.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, she would be my second guess.
Right.
Sad, no.
Yeah, she's doing. I'm thinking about going. I'm just, the only thing that might keep me from going is just the realization, like, yo, I'm really 28.
Right. Like, because my husband, you know, is the same way. He's like, I'm not really sure if I would go because. I mean, that was a long time ago.
Right.
And now I have to come up to that realization that I'm going to have to be adult.
Right. And Miss Bridget, I met Bridget in my freshman year in college,
mm-hmm.
also 10 years ago. It's crazy. We did a play together, Sherlock Holmes.
Yeah, and we were bad guys.
Yeah, we were bad guys.
We were the baddies.
Yeah.
We wanted to take Sherlock down.
Right. That was a great experience. That was a fun time.
That was so much fun.
That was a good time.
The only play I was ever in. Now that I think about it.
Yeah, that was the only one I did. Unfortunately, only because you know you gotta pay for books. You gotta get a job.
Yeah. You gotta have time.
You gotta study and all that stuff.
Right.
So yeah, I wanted to do more, and I wanted to do more with Mr. Bray.
Oh, he's so cool.
He's an awesome man.
I saw him on Facebook. Actually.
Yeah, me too.
Facebook, yeah.
Me too. But yeah. So you remember your name?
My name.
Yeah.
Leary.
That's right.
Miss Leary, because there was a whole role reversal,
right.
Gender reversal,
right.
thing going on there.
I was Cragen.
Cragen, yeah,
yeah.
You are a pimp.
Yeah,
that's what we thought.
Right, it was me and two
Jessica.
Two ladies, yeah. Well, you know, remember her name?
Yeah. Oh, her character name?
Yeah.
Oh goodness, no. I just know that. I mean, her name was Jessica. I don't
right.
know what her character's name was
right.
at this point.
Well, that was a good time, man.
Moriarty? No.
No, that was a villain.
Oh right.
That was a real villain. Professor Moriarty.
Well, we'll remember later.
Right.
We'll look it up on the internet.
Right. But the real reason why I got these ladies here is because they are very talented, very awesome cosplayers.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
We're talented. Thank you.
So, how did y'all get into the cosplay? How did y'all get started?
You should go first. Sure. Back at Hornville,
right.
I had a friend during lunchtime come up to me like in 2002, and she was like, hey, did you know there's an anime convention coming to town? It was New Moreno Con.
Okay.
And I was like, that sounds cool. I was like, what do you do at an anime convention? And she just happened to be like, well, you dress up. And I was like, I don't know how to do that.
Uh-oh.
So I went home to my mom, and I was like, Mom, there's a thing coming up, and I need a costume. My mom does not know how to sew.
Mm.
I didn't know how how to sew, so I asked my grandma, and she was like, I know how to sew, but I make Barbie clothes, so
that's enough. You make a Barbie.
So. Just put a bunch of those Barbie clothes together, sew those up.
Right, make them really big. And so I just put some thrift store clothes together, and what I saw there was so cool.
Mm-hmm.
I was just like, I have to keep doing this to get on that level.
I mean, thrift store Chan.
Yeah.
Thrift store Chan is everyone's first.
And it's been 14 years, and apparently it's not stopping anytime soon.
Oh, that's good. That's good. And what about you, Jet?
Well, let's see. I would say it was back in 2004, before the dawn of time. Before the dawn of MechaCon, it's in New Orleans now. It used to be in Lafayette, but they were starting this anime convention in Lafayette, my hometown, and they approached me at a GameStop where I was working and asked, do you want to be our promotional model for this anime convention? I'm like, what is anime convention? It sounds great. I like anime. Convention sounds fantastic. So about halfway through them explaining what I would get to do over there, I think I said yes, probably within the first couple of sentences.
Right,
so
right.
Dressing up, sure, that sounds great.
Right. Getting paid?
Well, no, it was volunteer
work.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's cool.
It was basically trading my time for getting to be at a convention. I just wear their logo, and, you know, and of course that made me hungry for more, so I wanted to dress up as other characters, you know, and so I had to learn how to sew.
Mm.
And I started asking people I knew who did sew for tips and tricks, watching YouTube videos on how to use a sewing machine.
Wow. That's
and
cool.
Just over time, got better and better.
How did y'all two meet?
That's kind of really funny, because Bridget and I actually knew each other before we knew each other.
Wow.
you're that girl in the Sakura costume.
Yeah.
Oh, you're that girl in the mascot costume for MechaCon.
Right. When she used to go to different conventions out of state and stuff and hand out stuff for MechaCon, when I didn't have anything to do at a convention, I would go over and be like, hey, do you need some help? And she would give me some stuff, and I would help hand out stuff.
Okay.
And so I would just always know, well, that's the girl that works for MechaCon. And it wasn't until I moved to Lafayette, like 4 years ago, that when I started working at Joanne's, where I work now, yeah, then I'd always see this girl with this red hair.
Hi!
Who'd come into the store.
Can you cut my fabric?
And
there's
then,
a lot.
Someone told me, like, that girl, like, she really loves your car, because I have, like, neon yellow car.
Wow.
Pontiac.
And she loves
Pontiacs.
And so, one day when she came into the checkout line, I was like, so I hear you like my car. And she's like, you're the one that owns the Pontiac?
The
and
yellow
I was like,
Pontiac.
I was like, yeah, that's me. And that was it. Like,
I think I said, cool. If you ever sell it, let me know. It's so pretty.
That's awesome. That's a very organic way to start a relationship and a friendship.
Yeah, pretty
yeah.
much. Just like, hi, I like your car.
So
my nice car, let's be friends.
It actually wasn't about anime or girl things. It was
no.
about a car.
About a
how
car,
about that?
Yeah.
So and y'all been y'all like formed a company or something?
Oh, we're a cosplay team.
Yeah.
Okay, a team.
It started off. It was Cute Classy Cosplay. That was actually Michelle and two previous people. And at some point she was looking for another cosplay partner, do things, not just cosplay at regular conventions, but do the World Cosplay Summit. And I was available, and we actually entered together, and we eventually changed the name to Cute Classy Chaos. I thought it needed to be freshened up, because
cool.
we already had two previous people in it, you know.
That's cool.
Kind of wanted to.
And we're kind of chaotic, so.
Yeah, we're a little more chaotic than most.
I mean, I definitely remember how that happened, because she came to a convention with me. She came to AKON with me, actually, and we had made some costumes together.
Oh,
and it was
cat girls.
Yeah, and it was kind of like a trial run. to see if we like really liked each other or just wanted to kind of be friends.
Okay.
It was like the final exam period of and, like any
right
semester.
Like, did we want to like actually spend a lot of time together?
Right.
So we were together for an entire weekend, and on the car ride home, she was like, "Do you think I can be like your partner and
like,
make stuff
maybe.
With you forever?
Yeah,
we
that's
could
cool.
be forever partners."
And I was like, "Yeah, okay.
That's awesome.
Yeah, that'd be cool."
That's cool.
We don't wear those costumes anymore, the cat girls. We need to
maybe
revamp
maybe.
Them, revitalize them. They're cute. They're from Escaflowne.
Okay.
The cat girl dancers, in case you're familiar.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, one of these days.
Yeah, sure.
What are we
doing? I was kind of like, in my mind when I was starting this this podcast, I was thinking that y'all was going to come dressed up.
She asked me
that. I said, should I? And she's like, no, I think it's just an interview. Most
right.
of it's audio.
Right. That's
so.
Like I, most of my episodes have been audio. But I figured I need cameras on y'all too.
Oh.
Right.
Well, next time we'll
shall
wear...
we do it again and do costumes?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay. Next time
you
we'll wear
do
costumes.
That.
Part
awesome.
Two, electric boogaloo.
There you go.
We'll do the cosplay.
Will you dance too?
Huh?
Will you dance too? Since it's electric boogaloo.
Sure. Let's. You want to dance?
Yeah. We'll
learn dance. We'll choreograph something for our next meeting.
I love idols, so
yes,
awesome.
It'll be a great chance to
she
learn dance.
She loves idols, and I like to act silly, so.
That's awesome.
Works out.
Exactly.
So, how, like, is the, have y'all reached the top of where y'all want to go, or is there many more levels to go?
No.
Are you surprised at how far y'all have come so far?
Yes.
It came very fast.
Yeah, all
for
of a
us.
Sudden, all of a sudden, we were entering the cosplay summit, you know, the World Cosplay Summit. We were going to St. Louis. Then we went to Chicago for the final round, and that was all within
That's
a span
awesome.
Of, what, 6 months?
Yeah.
Yeah. So over a span of 6 months, everything developed really quickly, and suddenly people knew who we were and what we were doing, and that was kind of exciting.
And now we work for conventions, so now conventions hire us to run their cosplay contests, and we do like 5 or 6 of those
right.
a year, and people invite us to be guests at their cons, and so the level from being like nothing to something in less than a year
we're
is really
being asked for. It's pretty cool.
That's cool.
It's like, do you mean the other cute classic chaos? Wait, are you sure? Oh, us. That's cool.
So people are recognizing you now. People
yes.
know where you.
Yeah.
People know about you. That's awesome. Do people like seek y'all out and try to book y'all for shows and stuff like that?
Sometimes. Oh, like the LSU thing coming up. I mean,
yeah, this
we were, yeah.
This Saturday, we'll be judging an LSU cosplay show
That's
on
awesome.
Campus. And we were actually busy, so they moved the entire show for
us. Oh, yeah,
so we could
true.
Make it.
That's a pretty good indication
wow.
that you're doing something right.
Yeah.
Like, oh, no, we'll move things around to accommodate you.
Wow.
That's so cool. Right,
wow.
so
makes
we feel kind of special.
Yeah, we feel special but bad. So.
Yeah, cool. We might have to take a pause. We're really going to play some pool.
Yeah,
so
fine.
We're going to stop this real quick. And... All right, folks, and we're back. We had to move to an undisclosed location because there was a lot of noise. People are jerks.
Undisclosed. I
mean,
undisclosed. I like that.
You're right. I mean, if you're familiar with the place, you probably know where it is.
Just don't tell anyone.
Right.
Then they'll all come here and take up the room, and then we can't do
yeah,
it.
Yeah, we can't do the podcast no more.
It's not good.
But yeah, it's like I was telling Michelle, as soon as the cameras roll, as soon as the mics turn on, that's when the circus comes.
Yeah.
That's when it happens.
Yeah, juggling monkeys and
everything. Right.
And just
right. I mean, it was really noisy.
Yeah, it's more of a pool tournament, but sure.
Right.
The circus pool tournament.
Right. Like, come on, man. Like, he saw, because where we was recording at, there's just a bunch of big windows, and he saw that microphone, two cameras.
Let's go there.
We have to play.
Next to the microphones.
Right, we have to play this pool
yeah.
tournament.
And
right
we
now.
Mentioned it a couple of times.
Yes.
Like, well, they're just kind of recording here. And he's just like.
Like, nope.
No,
don't
you're
care.
Not.
Don't care. So I really appreciate Michelle and Bridget for traveling with me to this undisclosed
yeah,
location.
That's
this
no problem.
This bunker 7 leagues under the sea.
Yes. elevator
right.
down.
Right. Passcode, retinal scans, mm-hmm. all that good stuff.
Retinal scan, that was fun.
Yep. But yeah, so we was talking before, during the setup, we was talking about, we went back to the 10-year reunion at Homeville, and I thought everybody knew about it, everybody was on Facebook, and Michelle didn't know about it, so I spilled the beans that, you know, Courtney, the person organizing the reunion, doesn't like Michelle. I mean, I didn't know.
This is your fault.
I played it off real cool, but earlier I was like, yeah, I'm going to that reunion. I sure am.
Yeah, but no, I don't know what happened. No, I'm like, Courtney doesn't have a problem with you, I'm sure.
No, I'm sure.
Well, yeah. It's probably because you're not on that Facebook.
We were friends like
be in the group.
Forever, mm-hmm. you know, in drama and in this and that. So I'm sure just 10 years have passed and I just slipped her mind.
Yeah, it's probably one of those, if I were organizing it, I'd be like, here's the group of all the people that care. And right. Michelle is not in the group of people that care about what's going on. So
right.
It's probably not. If,
sorry,
you know.
I don't care.
If I knew that you didn't know about it, I would have sent you an invite. Because that's probably what it was. Mm-hmm. Like, she started and like branched off and a bunch of people started sending it to a bunch of people.
It's cool.
Yeah.
It's not cool, but it's cool.
But yeah, so yeah, we was talking about cosplay and that y'all two are two cosplay rock stars, and yeah,
we
so
are rock stars now.
Y'all have to gotta make arrangements and y'all gotta disappoint some people. Be like, we can't do it because we're booked somewhere else. How is that?
Well, I guess if we're asked to do two things on the same day,
yeah.
Well, usually we have to disappoint someone. I mean, there's been a few times where there's been an event. That's why there's two of us. Actually, that's a good thing to mention.
That's what you always say.
It used to be, we'd have to be like, I'm sorry, I can't make it for this. Oh, I'm sorry, I can't be there for that. But now that we're cute, classy chaos, we're together on everything, you know, there have been events where only Michelle could go or only I could go. That way we're still, you know, we're still represented
That's
in
cool.
some capacity.
That's
so a
cool.
lot of times we'll send like one person out because like I work, you know, with my work, sometimes I'm required to do something kind of short notice
mm-hmm.
and then, you know, kind of works yeah. out that way. So
I think it's really cool that y'all being recognized and people like they want y'all. Yeah, they want y'all team, y'all cosplay team. How does that make y'all feel?
Really,
pretty good. Kind of surprised.
Yeah.
I'm surprised, yeah.
When was the first time that somebody, a stranger, recognized y'all and was like, I need y'all for my event? When was that?
I guess, I mean, I've always been like semi-recognizable because mm-hmm. I've been cosplaying a long time. So I get people all the time who are like, Michelle!
Yeah,
I'm trying to get in costume. And like, I'm like, I don't know who you are. But yay! But, Bridget and I are still like fairly new together as a team. I'm
trying to think of when someone specifically, because I mean, same thing for me. Like I did the mascot thing for so long.
Christian
you know.
Does that to us a lot, though.
Yeah.
When you say,
do you still have those T-shirts? I always wanted one. I never got one.
Oh, the MechaCon
yeah.
shirts. I mean, well, they weren't mine to give out,
okay.
but I mean, the company still has. I mean, they sell them
That's,
at the yeah.
But even
I
though,
may have a spare
oh,
somewhere though. Because occasionally, you know, I'd be like, oh, I'm. Cold. Can I have an extra T-shirt? I probably have one from some year.
But people, yeah, every now and then we'll just get some people who are like, oh, what?
BayouCon. BayouCon, remember? Justin was like, if you guys could help us, that would be great. That was a very, like, I know that you two work on all of these. I would say that was the first time we were recognized to get, or asked.
Sure.
Go with that. There's got to be some other time. I don't know.
We try to secretly not make a big deal out of it.
Yeah. Because we stay kind of busy. But, no, that's not why. I don't know.
No, we don't want it to get to our heads.
Yeah, that too.
That's cool.
Bring us back down.
What's the coolest place cosplay has taken y'all? What's, like, the most awesome place you've been?
Chicago! Chicago,
awesome,
Illinois.
Man. That's awesome.
That was the finals for the World Cosplay Summit. And we were this close to going to Japan, at least, you know.
Okay.
Maybe it was this close.
Yeah, okay, this. There were a lot of great teams. Like, it's hard.
I bet.
Because you're up against the most amazing talent, like the best in show, like every best in show, mm-hmm. like the best of all those people
is what you're
up against. So you're like, okay, I guess I'm supposed to be here.
Yeah, that's cool. That's cool. So how did it feel to be amongst the top of the top?
Ah!
The best of the best.
It felt like, almost with a little bit of, oh crap.
Definitely didn't think we were going to make it there. Like, I've been trying for the summit for 3 years. 2 years, I think, before I met Bridget, and I never even, like, made it close. I was always, like, way down at the bottom. And so Bridget and I, the first time we competed, we got second place, like, automatically. Like, I did not expect to get that
first try.
And I kind of knew it was coming because I was standing right next to the judge, and I saw something that said cute on the award, and I was just like, I think that's me. Yay! So I kind of cheated. I was like, who is it? It's me! And so that sent us to finals, and I'm so happy because that's been my goal as a cosplayer, to go to Japan and represent all cosplayers.
That's awesome. That's
for,
like,
America.
Yeah, represent the country.
Right.
It's such a huge honor.
That's so the winner of Chicago is like the Miss America.
That year, Chicago.
Okay.
It's different locations every year, but yeah, that would be like Miss USA,
pretty much.
Cool. Yeah, so that, yeah. So we would be Team
USA. So like the Japan finals, they had people from all around the world.
Yes. They've got Italy. You've
got
Brazil.
Person from every country.
One team from every country that participates.
That's
phenomenal. There's 23 countries.
Y'all gonna get it.
We are.
Glenn said so.
Yeah.
We know it must be true.
So
absolutely.
He's never steered me wrong.
That's kind of what's been taking us so long to get here, is because in June we're trying again, and this time we have to go to New Jersey.
y'all had to compete in Lafayette to get to New Jersey?
Well, it's done a little bit differently this year. Up until now, they've had a preliminary round. And then there will be like, what, 5 preliminaries-ish? And so there'll be one in like California, one in Utah, I don't know, one in Louisiana, maybe, possibly, Texas. And then of all those places around the U.S., there's a first and a second place that all go to finals. Not every second place goes. Some of them choose not to or whatever. But
you have to pay your way a second place.
So that means we paid our way. blood, sweat, and tears. But then, yeah, the final round is usually once, you know, you're getting down to your one Team USA. But this year now, they're just going with straight up finals, and it's in New Jersey. So you have to bring your A game. There is no, you know,
there's no second
let's
chance.
Improve
yeah.
it for the finals.
Right.
Like, no, you this is yeah. finals. So
no cutting corners.
Right,
right.
Like, when we competed in St. Louis, we went, and then we had like 6 weeks to make improvements before we went to Chicago this year. It's just you're going to New Jersey, and that's it. There's no making improvements. You just bring your best.
I tell y'all like this. I'm really proud of the both of you, and I really hope y'all make it.
Thanks.
I really hope
y'all
go.
I really hope so, too.
That's awesome. Because, like, I do a segment at the end of the show called 4321, and the last question is the number one place on Earth that you haven't been that you want to go. And mine is Japan.
Yeah.
And,
too.
That's phenomenal. So I really hope y'all make it.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. But y'all got it, man, because y'all too awesome to not make it.
Well, thank you.
You know?
Yeah,
I've seen y'all stuff on Facebook, and it's really cool. Before we go any further, y'all want to give out any social media or anything like that, so people can check out your stuff?
Facebook.com/cuteclassychaos. That's how you find
our... Spelled normally, no K's, anything?
No
like
K's,
just,
nothing crazy,
right.
Just normal. Cute, classy, chaos, all one word,
cool.
Right after
we
the
We should have done that, though. That would have been more chaotic.
What?
Put some K's in the...
Yeah. Well, I mean, sometimes I spell it in caps, like the chaos part.
It would have been a little difficult if you had 3 K's.
That would be a no.
Especially from Louisiana.
Yeah.
That would be terrible.
That would be terrible.
Yeah,
that was better than our other team name. That's not what I signed up for. That we other team name we wanted.
That's us. We do not have an Instagram.
No.
We have a Twitter. It's C3 Cosplay.
Oh yeah, Twitter. Read so the tweets can, that we tweet. I don't know what you
which aren't very
the past tense of tweet.
Which aren't very many, but we reply to our tweets, so that's. Yeah. We do that. We
so
don't
if you
tweet,
have tweeted us, we tweet you.
Right. We don't tweet, but we twit at people.
We have tweeted on occasion.
So why not Instagram? That'd be Mayfield, right?
We each have our own
personal
Instagrams.
I'm Bridget. Wait, no, I'm not. What is my Instagram? What's my Instagram?
It's Ooh-la-la.
It is. Is it Miss Ooh-la-la?
Yes.
Yeah, Miss Ooh La La. That's my cosplay name. That's
on Instagram.
Right.
And
thank you,
my
Michelle.
Instagram name is Sanctuary Memory.
Sweet.
Mm-hmm. And that's our cosplay names, coincidentally. So.
There you go.
Guess we can go.
So do y'all look at other cosplayers? Because I know there are people who do really, really well at cosplay. Like, that's their career. So is that something y'all want to
do? Like Yaya.
Yeah, Yaya. Huh?
Yes. I would love to be Yaya number two.
Yaya.
I suppose. And I know
really
she's got a lot of like haters out there too. And that, you know what? Yeah. I don't totally like disagree or agree with any of that. All I have to say is that she's the only person that's ever really achieved anything like that with cosplay. Like,
yeah,
she has achieved the highest level, and I would love to just
right. It's like,
get up there with her, even with all the hate, you know.
No matter
that's just
how
people.
You feel
I mean,
about
that comes
her.
With the territory.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's like, you know what? If people are gonna hate us for it, if we ever do become Yaya famous, you know,
mm-hmm.
I'm okay with that.
Bring it, bring it.
Right.
People already hate me for other stuff
right.
I do, so
right.
why not?
Yeah, right.
You know,
yeah.
It's like no matter how you feel about her, you have to appreciate what she's
mm-hmm.
done.
She's
I mean,
in your head, so she wins, you know, like
right,
it, yeah.
Right.
You're 14.
You're thinking about her, but she's not thinking about
she's
you.
She's not thinking about her. She's got
14 years.
She's got 99 problems, and you ain't one of them.
I've
so.
Never been able to walk into a Joann's until this year and buy a specific pattern to
yeah,
make a costume.
Patterns and fabric.
Or,
and
yeah, things like that.
She
so.
Is a brand.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and that
is.
I can appreciate.
Yeah, we would love that.
I can't pay my rent doing what I'm doing.
Right, right. No.
That's why I work at Joann selling her stuff. So.
Right, but no, but that's the story though. That's the struggle, and I think all creatives go through that. And I think that's what makes us good at what we do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because like you don't get paid for it, but you still do it because you love it.
Right,
right.
Know? So and in that love is when it really you start developing it. And that's when it really becomes good. And that's when it becomes a career.
Yeah. But we do look at other cosplayers because what we do at conventions is they pay us to run their contests. So what we do is we define the rules. We get people to sign up. We get the prizes together. And we hire other cosplayers to come and be the judges. So we're not always the judges ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
So that means that we're spending a lot of time looking at other cosplayers' social accounts and seeing how good they are. If they make their own stuff, how they interact with their fans.
Mm-hmm.
And what kind of following they have, you know.
So that way we can bring them in. And we don't always pick people who are super famous. We like to give a shout-out to the underdog, too.
Yeah,
because
mm-hmm. yeah, y'all know how it feels, how it is to be just starting out and stuff like that. But that's
right.
Cool, man. See, like that's why I do the podcast and I get people like y'all on it because I love people who are passionate about what they do, and who knows where they'll take you, you know? That's
mm-hmm.
very important. And I think the world needs more people like that, you know? Because there's a lot of people.
I think so, too.
I think there's a lot of people who make compromises who are just cool with just sitting at a desk their whole lives, you know what I mean?
Oh,
yeah.
No.
Like, no hobbies, no creativity, no
I've
passion,
I've worked a
nothing.
Desk job. It was really hard.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it is.
Yeah.
I had to jump off a bridge, man. Like, like y'all say, like, y'all not making.
An airplane.
Right.
Live life on the edge.
You know, like, y'all say y'all not making too much with the cosplay yet.
Yeah.
I don't make anything doing the podcast. I don't make
that
anything.
That can turn into stuff, too.
Right, right. I hope so, man. Like,
people get,
cameras ain't cheap.
Yeah.
Microphones not cheap.
They not.
But it's a lot of fun, man. I'm going to do this every week, and I love to do it, man.
Cool.
It's a lot of fun.
I love me some podcasting. Have us on anytime.
Yeah, most of what we do is definitely out of pocket. If we travel somewhere, sometimes we get food
Sometimes they'll give us, you know.
Yeah. Sometimes they'll feed us. No. Most of the time, right? It's just entry into the place. Right. But sometimes they'll be like, well, you know, we sold a lot. So here's an extra.
Here's a bonus.
Yeah, here's an extra $30. Here, go have some Mexican.
Here's your rations for the day. Do not stop on the con floor, please. You know, I mean, it ranges from either or. We don't work for any British people, though.
So. No, but you seem to like being
British.
I don't
know why. Sorry.
I guess you want to go to England one day.
Let's go. Let's do a con over there.
Okay.
That's awesome.
BritCon.
Yeah, y'all do that, and I'll come and I'll document it.
Okay.
That'll work. You know, it's just the whole paying your way thing. It might be kind of rough, but we'll work it. We'll work it out.
You start a GoFundMe account. We'll get you there.
Yeah. So, do y'all have any, like, heroes of cosplay? Anybody outside of Yaya that y'all look at? That y'all admire? I admire just Kanigri. But, yeah. You know, perhaps for other reasons.
I mean, really, the only cosplayer that I really, really, really look up to is Yaya. Because she's the only one I can think of that's achieved, like, a brand. Mm-hmm. You know, like, I mean, Jessica Nigiri... I mean, people know her, but it's not the same.
Yeah.
No, she's definitely not the same.
I love cute cosplayers. So, shout out to my girl, Sparkle Pipsy. Bridget knows I love me some Sparkle Pipsy.
Sparkle Pipsy.
Rin. I love Rin. Rin was my very first cosplay senpai. And so, for her to give me an award a few years ago, like, was a big stepping stone for me. For her to recognize my work, because I always followed her and looked up to her. And my girl Invol,
yeah.
I love Invol. I invite her to everything because I just love her so much and she's so nice. So for me, it's not always about like what they do.
Mm-hmm.
It's about who they are. And I love cute people.
I guess I do kind of have some heroes. If you remember Grin and Cherry from a while back, Limit Break cosplay. They were different than just cosplay judges or cosplay. I mean, they didn't even do the summit or anything like that. They were on stage. They were the life and the heartbeat of every cosplay contest that they were a part of. You know, they just had this incredible energy, especially Cherry. She had this fiery red hair, short red hair. She was always in cosplay, though, so no one really ever noticed, I guess. But just people who were... more than just someone that's wearing a costume, but you know, people who have that energy on the con floor and then on stage, I admire them.
Cool.
So shout out to Limit Break, even though they haven't been a cosplay team in
years,
over 10 years.
But I know you really like them because
I do love them.
You always like
bring them up constantly and bring up Cherry constantly.
And you're always like, let's be the next Limit Break. Because...
I think it's
because
she's secretly like my cosplay waifu. Because she's just, I've just always had this huge, I've had like a huge woman crush on
Cause
Cherry forever.
I always try to like hire an MC or something for an event and we're just like, why don't we just do it?
We'll just do it. We can just do it.
You know, Grin and Cherry used to do that, so why don't we do it?
And I'm in radio. Let's do it.
Right.
So.
That's awesome. Speaking of that, how is that? How did you get into that?
The radio. Actually, partially cosplay related, sort of. I was doing a model search in Lafayette, right here in Lafayette, however many years ago it was. Barney's Police Supply and Gun Range. They were looking for three angels, Barney's Angels. So I listened a lot to Rock 93.7, a now defunct rock station.
Sorry,
if you want to, hold on. There are people watching.
Right. When the cameras are off, that
excuse
that
us. Anyways,
I won't do it again. Barney's needed three angels.
Yeah, they need three angels. I kept hearing these ads. You think you can be one of Barney's angels? Apply. Go to rock937fm.com. All this stuff, and I was like, yeah, I'll apply for that. Sure. Uploaded some photos. Got picked to go do this meet and greet thing. They narrowed it down to 10 contestants. I was one of the 10 contestants. And then from there, they did a runway thing in three. And then I didn't get in the top three, which at first sucked. And then I got offered a job by the radio station that interviewed me. They're like, the morning show guy was like, you give great interview. Do you want to be on the air? And I was like, are you serious? I mean, sure. He's like, you're full of personality. Why not? So started on a show called Two Hot Chicks on a Saturday Night. It was a really dirty, raunchy, fun radio show. And then from there, I moved on to 94.5 KSMB. I had an anime name on that station. I was Serena.
Okay.
Because there was already a Brittany, so Bridget was, you know, too close. And then Rock 101 in Lake Charles took me over there. And then right back over here now, I'm on 106.3 Radio Lafayette.
Look at you.
That's my life. I did cosplay. But no, my first air name was Miss Ulala, which was my cosplay name. So kind of combined.
It's all ties together. Yeah. What's the coolest thing y'all seen in at a cosplay convention? What's the coolest cosplay?
Oh.
Like, wow. God, that must have took years to make or something like that.
I remember there was a Big Daddy from Bioshock. Yeah, but that actually had the working spinning drill. And I was just like,
I remember that.
And it was new, like, at the time. Like, I don't remember if it was Akon one year, but I saw that on stage and I liked to die.
I think it was.
It was resuscitated.
Do you remember?
That was pretty amazing.
When Cupcake did their
transformation.
And they transformed and it just
kept going into this rainbow of transformation.
The costume transformed?
Yeah. The costume.
Well, it was the Alice.
Yeah. They Alice changed from one costume to another and it was just...
I've seen
the progress pictures and I still don't know how it works.
Yeah, it's pretty amazeballs. Like, I think it's... witchcraft is how it works.
I'm pretty sure everything to do with witchcraft.
<It's> witchcraft.
It might be.
Maybe.
You just got some. That's another trick you got to learn.
Yeah.
Another hobby you got to take.
We're still mastering witchcraft. It's just coming along very slowly.
Right.
Our form of witchcraft was our with that dragon head and our wings lighting up. We made stuff light up on stage before.
That's cool.
So we've delved.
What's the worst cosplay mishap that y'all have had, that y'all have encountered?
You go first.
You like my story so much.
Because it's more...
It's depressing. Okay, so because Rin is my cosplay senpai so much, and I love Rin so much, One time I made this like really big costume with a bunch of flowers on it, and the skirt weighed 22 pounds by itself, so it was really heavy.
Wow.
And I went to go enter it into a contest where Rin was judging, which is not the same contest she gave me an award for. This time I did not win an award because when I was judging, she was like, wow, this is so cool. Can I like turn around and see the back? And I was like, yeah, sure. I was like, The way the thing sits, it's so tight and so heavy that I took a breath that was too deep and the snap popped undone and the skirt fell down.
Wow.
To the floor.
Like during the judging?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
I was just like, boop. And I was just like, well, just pull that back up.
Let's try this again.
I mean, I was wearing something underneath.
Thank you.
Yeah, right.
But it was still pretty embarrassing because I was just like, just happened. This is my life. So the only thing she said afterwards was like, yeah, nice costume.
Nice if it stayed on.
Thanks.
That's funny. Oh man, unfortunate.
I'm trying to think. I've tried to like drown out most of my unfortunate cosplay. Let's see. I do remember very recently backstage when I had to fix the collar of my Cosmos costume, had broke, like a little piece broke where the thing that holds up the zipper and everything kind of flops around if it's not up there, broke.
Mm.
So I had nothing to fix it with except a roll of tape that I was not allowed to touch by someone backstage that thought their tape was made of freaking gold, I guess. So no. So I fixed it with a safety pin, you know.
Uh-oh.
And at some point it unpinned and stuck into my neck.
Oh.
I mean, it was pretty brutal. No blood was spilled on the costume.
Oh.
But I had a nice little like I had tried to poorly attempt to commit suicide. It was not really. It was just this little pin scratch across my neck
mm-hmm.
with little, you could tell it had bled a little.
Wow.
And I was just like, wow, this is But I didn't want it to open on stage, so it was just uncomfortable.
War wounds.
That's the worst one I can think of.
Cosplay is dangerous. For y'all that don't know, cosplay is dangerous.
Cosplay could cost you your life. not really. It's not supposed to.
Right.
Man. If it ever does, then I've had a wig kind of start to slip off, and I'm just sitting there like.
But has anyone ever stolen your wig?
No one's stolen it. Someone stole your wig from your head. I remember that story.
Someone did steal my wig.
My wig? What?
What? Why would
Michelle
that...
has unfortunate situations.
Why would that happen?
Sometimes. Because there'd be... cosplayers be cray
sometimes.
Cosplayers
are cray sometimes. And one time I was at MechaCon, and I was wearing a wig, and there was some people...
people thought things that was their first mistake. They thought things
such as I don't like Michelle, and they said, so the best thing to do because I don't like Michelle is to steal her wig. I was sitting down just like this, and I was talking to a friend just like this.
Right.
Wig ninja. We'll call them wig ninja.
They came up behind me and they said, that's mine. And they took it.
Did the wig cap come off with it?
No, so I was just wearing a wig cap, I had a bald head, and they took my...
Rude.
I was like, what?
That really happened.
Someone stole my wig.
So many questions.
Yeah, it was special.
Many questions. Did you know the person?
Yeah, I knew the person.
Who committed this wig jacking?
Well, I used to know the person after they took my wig. I wasn't too sure anymore.
That's question number one. Question number two, why do you think they took your wig?
What
did you do to this person?
Kind of falling out or something.
Yeah, we had a little spat, and apparently the little spat turned into a big spat, and nobody notified me.
When conventions are so full of drama, especially with younger... I mean, this happened to you when you were, 20 or something.
Yeah, barely out of high school. Mm-hmm. So,
and anyone who's... I mean, no offense to the people watching / listening, but right. when you're under, 20... Or sometimes things that seem like they're your whole world, and it makes you more angry. And really, it's just a drop in a giant ocean.
I mean, back then,
act impulsively and impetuously.
We're not even talking about a good wig. We're talking about an eBay wig.
At least we're not talking about Party City wig. You know,
we're talking about something that came off of eBay. Yeah, I was just like, that's fine. And I went to a wig store in Lafayette, and I just bought a new wig. So
that's very upsetting. I didn't know that happened. That's a shame, man.
That's when you wait until...
I'm sorry to hear that.
I have tons of stories.
You may not have enough time.
Just out here having cosplay beef. It's just like wars going on over here.
One time
Crazy.
It was not cosplay beef, but one time I was taken into security because somebody thought I stole something from the dealer's room.
Mm. What's the dealer's room?
The vending room.
The vending room where you go in... And merchants are selling things.
Anime.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Clothing.
And so I went to one of the vendors, and they were selling Japanese snacks. And so I had bought I don't remember, it was a rice cake or something. But the guy didn't have any bags.
Mm-hmm.
So I took my rice cake with me, and I was holding it, and I went and I looked somewhere else at a different table, and I didn't want to buy anything, so I walked away. And that person thought that I stole something from their table.
Because you were holding it like
this. Right, because I was holding it, because I had a costume. I was just I'm going to hold this.
Mm-hmm.
And they told the con I stole from them, so the con arrested me.
Wow.
And I was like, but nobody ever told me what I did. They were just like, come with me.
Well, they didn't arrest you. They just security escorted you or something.
Right. And I was like, for what? And they're like, you have to come with me right now. And they took me to the little security room where they put all the bad people. And I was just sitting there for a half hour.
Just want my rice cake.
And I was like, is anyone going to tell me what I did? And the thing was is that they know who I am because I worked for them for a bunch of years before that.
Okay.
And so they didn't know how to tell me that they thought I stole something. So finally they just had the owner come in Michelle, did you steal from these people? And I was like,
what?
It was that all?
What?
Yeah, because you said arrested. So I'm trying to picture you in a cosplay uniform with a mugshot.
Yeah, I was picturing you in the back of a police car and going to the holding area where they take away your phone and
that downside look.
It's kind of, yeah. That's how I felt. It was Saint kind of like being arrested because they were just like, just all of a sudden it was like, you come have to with come me. With me. And then they put you in this little room where there's nobody else except like this rent-a-cop.
But at the con, right?
Right, at okay, the con. Yeah. And I'm just like,
I was picturing like Orange is the New Black. Like it was.
And they're like, we can't tell you. And I'm like, you can't tell me why I'm with the rent-a-cop? And they're like, no. And I'm like, oh. My mom's going to be so disappointed. What have I done?
How long was this? This was a long time too?
Oh yeah, this was when MechaCon was still in Lafayette. So this was like 9? Well, MechaCon's 10.
2011.
So
2010.
So this has if MechaCon's 10, then yes, this has.
I think 2010 was maybe the last year it was in.
Yeah. So it was. Like that. It was at least 6 years ago.
Oh wow. That's I didn't know it's that deep. I didn't know.
Sometimes that deep. Unfortunate a lot of, situations.
A lot of things going on in these kinds. I didn't know that.
It was all because somebody did not give me a bag for my rice cake.
All he needed was a plastic shopping bag.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Snatching wigs. Like, have y'all heard of anything worse than that? Maybe not necessarily with y'all, but.
People have done.
Sabotaging costumes and stuff like that?
People do that kind of stuff all the time.
Yeah.
You
gotta protect your neck, man.
Yeah.
You gotta watch yourself.
Yeah, you do.
If you make anybody angry in the cosplay community, they'll come after you. It's a serious sport.
They'll hunt you down.
Yeah, because I know. Yeah. I mean, I know y'all personally. You know, yeah. And I know that y'all are very sweet and very nice girls. But that's why I assume that all cosplayers are like that because I've seen them, you know, on YouTube.
They're not.
They range from really sweet, really chilled out, really laid back to. Like seven kinds of crazy
They take it to the dark side. They take it to another level.
Some people, I mean, it's kind of like anybody.
That's disappointing.
It's a mixed bag, you know? It's just like any sport. You know, you're going to have like normal people and crazy people. Yeah. They're all, you know? Similar interests.
And it's like there's no one really in between, so it's either really nice or really crazy. Wow. There's no one who's like slightly crazy.
I think I'm only slightly crazy.
So,
I like to think I'm in the middle.
Because it's anime, it's manga, it's video games. Like, this is all positive things. It's supposed to bring joy and happiness. I can't imagine it being like dark. There's a dark side to it.
Oh yeah.
Awesome. If you pronounce something wrong and someone is like,
they get a little bit
Or
like if you mess up their music cue on stage, you never know, you could be beheaded. It ranges.
People are always, but now that we're older, we don't fall into a lot of that. Mm-hmm. So
age has to do with it, for sure. Like, I know whenever I was first getting started in the whole, like, anime mascot representing a con thing, you know, I didn't realize that so many other people would want to do that and would not like me because that's what I was doing. Right. And there's not a whole lot of openings, you know, at the time. I think MechCon was probably one of the only ones using live people to represent their characters, you know. Mm-hmm. And so we got a lot of attention, me and the other girls who also did it. You know, it wasn't always just, you know, there's two of us, but we got a lot of crap for it, I would say. Just people being like, oh, you're booth babes. It's like, well, a booth babe is a girl in a short, showing her midriff t-shirt that's representing, you know, whatever table she's working at. Right. We're more than that. We have to be professional. We're out there to, like, talk to people, get the crowd excited, inform people, you know.
Booth babe is just eye candy.
Yeah, booth babe is just eye candy. I like to think that they're a little more selective with somebody who's going to represent a brand. Because
you have to be able to talk.
Right, you have to be able to talk to people.
And communicate and sell things.
You know? Right, yeah, essentially that's what you're doing. You're like a sales floor associate, you know, working for a con as opposed to just being at the booth while other guy handles the money, you know.
Right.
You're not handling money or merch. You're passing out flyers and information verbally. So it's different.
So is there some distinction between the two, like booth babes and cosplayers? Is that like
definitely,
war between
them? Yeah. Well, they're not a war. It's just either you're a booth babe and you wear a t-shirt or you wear a provided costume or a cosplayer where your creativity has been poured into this thing that you're wearing. So, I mean, there's a difference, but I wouldn't say there probably is a war and I'm just,
it's a secret. Too, it, yeah.
I'm just too out of the,
yeah,
I
you
don't care enough.
There you go. We shouldn't care.
Like, you can be a booth babe. That's cool. You can always start selling one day.
There are people like that, like Bridget, who don't really care. And that's the way you're supposed to be. But then there are people who... then there are people who are very much like
purists.
Yeah. You booth babe, and that's all you do, and you can't hang with us.
That's what was upsetting, is people just assumed because I was representing a convention and a character they created, they didn't realize how many hours of sewing I put into this, or how many hours of, you know, sewing I put into costumes that weren't related to the con, because all they could see was, you're representing these people, and you're getting a free ride at all these places we want to go. And it's an unfair assumption, because there are talented people that choose to also booth babe so they can go places for free, you know, because they be broke like me most of my life. So
is there any more common misconceptions about cosplayers? Because like, y'all already broke my heart. I thought y'all was all sweet and local otakus, you know, just people who love the culture, and apparently there's a dark side of the force.
The dark side. Yes, they just don't get cool red lightsabers or anything. Right.
I mean, we cosplayers fight about everything, especially now because the community is getting a lot of attention because now, you know, we're on TV. And we're being branded, but people are doing TV series about us. They're movies. We were like the nerds when I first started out. People, you didn't really want to talk about us, and now everyone wants to be like us and go to Comic Cons and stuff. And that's kind of weird, and that's kind of making people be like, well, you're a fake cosplayer, or you're a real cosplayer. Yeah. And
that's not fair to anybody.
If you buy your costume, then you're not a good cosplayer. If you make your costume, then you make it the wrong way, and you're still not a good cosplayer. And so we nitpick at each other. It's like a high school in there. And so the best thing to do is just be like, you're good no matter what.
Right.
And just try to stay out of it.
And just stick with your own team.
Right.
That's all you need. That's cool. I'm glad that y'all above that. You know,
it's hard.
I bet.
Bridget's better about it.
I'm not sure how, but I'm glad. Bridget's better about it
because she's going on. Right, because she
I'm like, they love us, and Michelle's like, they really don't. I'm like, they sent us a smiley face, and she's like, yeah, that was a sarcastic smiley face.
I'm more of a type of person who like looks at everything, and then if someone says something that's kind of off putting, then I get mad, and I'm like, you are going down. And then I have to like step back and be like, you know what,
Bridget, what do you think? Who are they? Okay,
I'm way past my 20s. I gotta chill. I'm gonna ruin the good thing that I'm building here.
Right.
So yeah, I have to be like, Bridget, did you see what they said? And she's like, I don't think they meant it like that. I'm like, okay, if you say so.
It's my attitude is not narcissistic, but it's like, well, why wouldn't they love us? We didn't do anything wrong.
Right. So it's good.
That's how I feel about things, too.
Yeah. It's good to have Bridget, because otherwise I'd probably be less liked.
No, you'd just be mad at people for things that they didn't mean.
That's true, too.
Right. I'm going to ask y'all a question. You can say, I plead the fifth, if you don't want to answer.
Ooh. Okay.
Have y'all personally sabotaged anybody else?
Let's see. Personally? Like, not in cosplay.
Yeah, not in cosplay. No. I've licked someone's toast before, but I mean.
You want to tell that story? I'm sorry. I'm probably being real loud. Yeah.
No. I'm sorry. I don't think they've noticed. Okay.
Yeah, I don't think you've noticed.
They're all so calm.
Yeah. Somebody.
Going in off to their. Their studies or whatever.
Computing.
Yeah.
I used to work in a restaurant, and there was a waitress that I did not like. You know, there's a front of the house, back of the house war thing going on. Yeah, sometimes when you're really busy and the waitresses are just like, can you hurry up with the food? And you're like, dude, chill.
He was in the back?
Yeah, I was a chef. I went to culinary school.
Okay, that's right.
So yeah, I know this is not what you're supposed to do. But she made me so mad one time, and then she ordered, it wasn't even food for a table, it was food for her. And she was like trying to rush it, and I was like, ma'am, you got to chill, because you're not even a customer right now.
you're just on break.
Mm-hmm.
So I licked her toast and I put it on her plate.
I mean, oh my.
I bet you know who you are now because I never told you that I did this. I'm not sure if I'm sorry or not yet.
Just think, the toast is
But I'm kind of sorry because I shouldn't have done that.
Extra delicious that day.
Yeah, I licked it and then I put butter on it and then I put it on.
You didn't even know.
I was mad, but this is extra tasty.
Right.
Thank you, Michelle.
So, like, because she didn't like me either, so we were just kind of bickering. And I was like, I'm going to show you bickering. And I looked around and I was like...
Yeah.
So I never sabotaged anyone in costume, and that was the first and only time I ever messed with anyone's food. I promise, because I know what it's like to work in a restaurant, and I never send my food back because I don't want anyone to treat me the way I treated her.
Right.
Oh dear. Never sending food back ever.
Wow.
I've seen what people do in restaurants.
I've seen waiting. That's good enough.
I mean, I saw somebody put a screw in someone's food before, and that's just...
Wow. Whoa, that's too far.
That's another level, man.
Right, so, I mean, all I've ever done is lick someone's toast. That's...
Yeah. At least if I do something, it's going to be hilarious and thought out. Like, there were these... Well, I guess you can't really say sabotage, but just left a very unamusing present for someone.
Wow.
This involves some setup. So, okay, there were these giant monster truck things. This was before I even cosplayed. Like, one of my first apartments ever. They would double park, both of these guys that lived upstairs from me.
Mm-hmm.
Lived downstairs from me. I lived upstairs from them, me and my roommate.
Mm-hmm.
And one of them did hit my car. Mm-hmm. And I know it was them. But it was while I was parked, asleep, whatever. But I knew it was them because I saw in their car and mine, and I confront them. I'm like, hey, look, it was you, obviously. No, I don't know what you're... I never parked next to you. And I'm like, I know better than that.
Right,
you know, so it was one of those situations. And so we had cats. We had cats in our apartment. We had litter. And it was around Christmas time. It was really cold, you know. Everything was decorated with everything, and so I scooped some of the cat poop and put it in a little box, and then the box I wrapped with Christmas paper.
Oh, that's so nice.
And I put a little bow on it, and they always had this habit of leaving a little crack in the window, right? Mm-hmm. So it was a small enough package that one of the offending trucks, I just kind of put it in through the window, and just, I wish I could have seen them open it, but I didn't, regretfully. I wish I could lie to you and say I did, and it was funny, but I'm sure it was hilarious.
Right.
I know they probably never knew why or anything, but that didn't matter. I just wanted them to open it on Christmas Day and be like, that's what you get.
You know what you did? As far as cosplay, I would never mess with somebody's costume.
I couldn't.
Costume.
It would hurt me more. To ruin someone else's costume that is probably beautiful and hard labor.
Right.
Yeah.
Yo, that's so many questions. We could talk. This might be an extra long episode.
Cut it up into a couple.
Yeah. I know y'all got things to do. I don't want to keep y'all. But Michelle's married.
Yes.
Does your husband cosplay with you? Or?
Not since we started dating.
Okay.
He used to. He had a cape, I remember.
Yeah.
His cape.
The story with my husband and I is kind of big and long, but basically, I was in a previous relationship that did not work out. I was engaged to somebody and we broke it off, whatever. So I met my current husband. Whoops.
You're only.
I met my husband.
I met the Josh.
I met my husband Josh on the internet. And we went out on our first date and I did not like him at all.
Wow.
can't imagine why.
But he liked me a lot. So he used to pester me a lot, like, just let me take you to dinner. Let's go out again, you know, blah, 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 blah. And I was like, whatever.
Why didn't you like him? It was a quick tangent.
I'm not really sure. I guess I just wasn't ready.
Because Michelle's default is I don't like. No, I'm kidding.
It's true. I defaultly don't like things. I just... Yes?
You like me.
I just wasn't feeling it, you know? So I was like, this isn't really going to work out. This is not what I thought. There were no fireworks. And I was like, I'm done. I'm just going to go on with my life. And he, in his mind, he was like, that's the girl I'm going to marry. Like, automatically. He says that all the time, so I guess it must be true. And I was just like, that's fine. And I just kind of kept hanging out with him for like 2 years before we actually started dating. And I was like, I do this convention thing. And he's like, well, I like conventions. And I was like, okay, well, I dress up at this convention thing. And he would come to some of them and dress up. And and I was like, okay, well, that's kind of cool now, because I've never had a guy that wanted to dress up in costumes for me. He wouldn't make them. He would buy them. Mm-hmm. Or whatever, you know, it doesn't matter. And then when we actually started dating, he just stopped. And I've asked him about it before, and he's like, well, I don't have to cosplay anymore because obviously you like me now. There you go.
I got you.
Yeah.
That's cool. That's cool, man. Well, in 3 years, huh?
Yes.
Yeah, that's cool.
It'll be 3 years in November.
Do you want him to get back into it, or?
I tell him that all the time. But it doesn't really bother me. Like, he's busy with his own thing. He's a big gamer.
Okay.
He plays League of Legends and WoW and all of that stuff. So we kind of have this compromise. I do my thing. He does his. We have rooms directly across from each other in the house. So that's our quality time together.
That's cool.
If he doesn't want to cosplay, that's cool. As long as he doesn't ask me to be a gamer, because I'm not really into...
Okay.
I'm into console games, but not computer games.
Me too.
And so that's kind of the thing.
Right there with you.
But I know that he would like me to cosplay from some of his games, so maybe we can reach
him. Yeah, that's that. Because I mean, the two worlds are very related. So
yeah. So. It's not like he doesn't do anything, because he does help me out a lot with my props, because he does woodworking.
Well, that's cool.
So anytime that Bridget and I need stuff like that, he helps us out with that kind of stuff. So he's kind of like a semi-cosplayer, I guess.
Cool. Maybe I don't care, but how do your parents feel about the cosplay? Like, do they say, I need to grow up, stop dressing up?
Oh, no. My parents, first of all, love it. My dad loves to make stuff. Like, that's he's cool. been making jewelry and, he welds, he solders, he even, like, made something for his motorcycle. He's crafty. So he's all about it. He loves it. We'll have a conversation about different types of glue, like, for, like, an hour, you know, about, the cement stuff, you know. Anyway, my mom thinks it's cool because she likes pictures, photos. That's cool. So she's like, wow, that looks like real hair, you know. Wow, I can't believe you made that, you know. So I'm always impressing her with, she always wanted to sew because my grandmother sewed. And my mom just never really got into it, but okay. Always was like, man, I should have done that. So it's like she kind of gets to live vicariously through me sewing part. So they like it.
My parents like it now. In high school, it wasn't that big of a deal. Then I got to college, and, you know.
He's still a kid in high school.
Right. Mm-hmm. And in college, I could remember my dad kind of being like, when are you going to stop doing this Sailor Moon crap? And I was like, I don't think I am. And he was like, aren't you getting kind of old to be playing dress up? And I was like, I don't know. And then I won my first award, and I showed that to my parents, and then it was like all of a sudden like,
see, it's not Sailor Moon crap, Dad.
Right, right.
Is it even Sailor Moon?
No, I've never cosplayed Sailor Moon before.
That's like the Coke of, like, soda. Like, right. You know, like, you want a Coke? Well, those are Dr. Peppers. Sure, I'll take one, but it's not a Coke.
Right.
With Sailor Moon.
Right.
I guess my parents were like, Legend of Zelda was
a lot of parents everything. Don't. A lot of parents don't understand until you present them with something
tangible. Right. So now my parents are, my mom shares everything I make on her Facebook.
That's cool.
She calls me every Saturday, every Saturday I'm entering a contest, and she's like, how was it? Did you win? And
you're still doing it, Mom.
Right. And stuff like that. And she's like, look at everything my daughter does now. Isn't that great? And I'm like, man, I wish it felt like this like 10 years ago.
Yeah.
But it's cool. I really like that my parents support me about it now.
That's cool. Yeah. So. I mean, better late than never.
Right.
Do you feel there's ageism in cosplay? Like, you got to be young to do it? Or what's the oldest y'all seen do it?
One of my friend's dad's cosplays, he goes by the name Father Person Parker. I don't know if you know him, but he's so
cool.
Well,
that sounds cool.
He's like, other than my dad, he's like the coolest dad ever. I have you know. Anyways, you know him, right? Yeah, your dad's really cool. Okay, other than our dads, he's like the third coolest dad. The third coolest dad ever. Oh no, Jamie Parker's dad. He used to help out on Mechacon staff, but he would do an incredible Master Roshi cosplay, which is an old man. So, and he's not even as old as the old man he was cosplaying, but it was great. Then he did Bridget from Guilty Gear. And Bridget's supposed to be a boy dressed as a girl,
right.
Like probably like 20 years old. And it was weird, but it was so funny. So I don't know how old he is, but he's got to be like...
I mean, he's a dad, so...
50s, 60s? Sure. 50s and 60s-ish?
That's cool.
No, I know a couple of older people who cosplay. And I've seen like great, like not old ladies, but older women do like Grandma Sophie from Howl's Moving Castle and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And I think that's great. I don't think you necessarily have to cosplay your age, but the fact that they can find something their age to cosplay is really cool.
That's cool. You have any advice for young cosplayers out there that might be discouraged because people are telling them that they're too old to be doing this or they just don't know how to get into it?
Mm-hmm.
What would your advice would be to the youngsters?
Getting into it now is so easy. Now you have the internet.
Yeah.
You can YouTube everything.
Yo, time out. Me and Michelle are at an age, like I'm 28. How old are you, Michelle?
28.
Yeah, that's what I figured that. We remember a time before Google. I feel like a dinosaur saying that, but there was a time before Google. There was a time before YouTube.
There was a time before iPhones. I see people post about that online all the time, like, we are the last generation to remember certain things.
Yes.
And it's like, when I think about it, we really are. I do remember my mom having, like, a car phone.
You know, you guys are both actual millennials. Like, I think I'm just before a millennial.
So I do remember my mom having a car phone. I do remember having to spend 10 cents for every text message.
Wow. And a rotary phone.
We will get back to that question about the advice, but we got to talk about this. Just being old, young old.
Old mofos.
Being young old. I remember... Trying to hit on girls and having to ask them if they had text messages.
You do know I'm older than you, right? You do know that.
I didn't know that, but I didn't know by how much. No, I believe that.
A few years.
I remember you telling me that when we met during Sherlock,
because
I was a freshman. And you asked, and I asked you. I think it was maybe a junior.
Like a junior,
yeah.
Couple times, junior. I'm 32.
Okay. Yes, so, it's not old.
No.
It's not old.
No.
It's young old. That's how I feel. I feel like I'm young.
It's old.
Right. Yeah. And I remember dial up.
Yeah.
And like every time my mom would call to check on me, she'd kick me off the internet because right.
You know, that
That's
thing.
Very accurate.
Yeah. You make that horrible noise. Like
they don't know nothing about that.
No. That's nothing.
That's a recording of it on YouTube. You can enjoy it.
I don't want to enjoy that.
Right.
I remember like I used to spend the night at like my grandma's house and like early in the morning there'd be nothing on the TV. Do you remember?
Yeah.
Remember that?
Like now it's 24-hour television.
Yeah.
1,000 channels.
Yeah, like if you fell asleep with the TV on, you just wake up and it'd just be like the weird color block screen.
Color bars.
Or paid advertisement. They don't have to do that anymore. I remember, now I'm going way back. I remember when Cartoon Network was just starting and they had advertisements on other channels about this network dedicated for just cartoons. And I had a little boy orgasm. Like, that was so awesome. Like 24-hour channel for cartoons? Oh, man.
That's the only reason I went to Grandma's house, because we didn't have cable at my house, but she did. Because she had cable, because she had pay-per-view for all the boxing games.
I really think that our generation was the best time to be a kid.
Yeah.
I think so, too. Cool. I had a Teddy Ruxpin. How cool was that? A talking teddy bear. Well, I have cooler stuff now, but he had a tape in his back. That you ever put in like Metallica or something crazy and he's just like my dad's tape collection and be like, what happens?
Oh man.
Never did that.
Man, so many things that happened in the 90s.
Yeah.
That kids don't even understand.
The best music happened in the 90s. The best video games happened in the 90s. The best anime happened in the 90s.
I can agree with that too.
What more could you ask for?
Yeah.
Just
how radio was better in the 90s.
Like I said, there was a time before Google, and I was a part of that.
Yeah.
I remember, like, I was talking with a friend.
Angelfire.com. There we go.
I had a tripod site.
Trying to talk to girls on AIM.
AIM. Oh, yeah. AIM. I didn't like Instant Messenger because my fingers are very... I cannot type still to this day.
So. I used to live on AIM.
Oh, yeah. I've been in maybe like 4 chat rooms ever in my life.
Yeah, that was a thing to do. Never interested. I remember if you had a phone that can go to AIM on your phone, you was a millionaire to me.
Yeah, I had a little Razor phone.
A Star Trek millionaire.
When I had one of them little flip phones, I was a cool kid in school.
Everybody had the Razor joint.
Yeah, I had a Razor. I was a cool kid because I remember that. Because I remember in college, I still had my Razor phone, and my ex-fiance plugged it into the wrong charger, and he blew it up, and I was so sad because I was like, now I have to upgrade from the Razor phone.
Look, if it makes you feel better, my first phone was a Nokia brick in college.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, like my freshman year in college, I had a Nokia brick.
When did you get your first cell phone?
In the 7th grade.
I got mine, I think I was 16.
Because I started staying after school, so my mom got me one, but I could only turn it on, you know, because it cost a lot back then. So I could only turn it on after school to call her to come pick me up from school.
Wow. It had one purpose.
Yeah.
One job.
Yeah, now it's on all the time.
Right.
Yeah, back then you couldn't actually, like, use the phone.
Yeah.
I was talking with a friend. Do you remember going to school back in Homeville? We had to take, like, we had to go take a tour of the library and had to learn to do a decimal system.
Yeah, they don't have to do that anymore.
I wonder if kids still do that.
Probably not. I don't think they even have that anymore.
Yeah, do they even go to libraries anymore?
That's what Josh asks me all the time. He's like, why is this library always so busy? They don't need the library. They have the internet.
Because that's where they use the internet, because they don't pay for it.
Right. It's just like
cheaper.
All those pieces of paper.
Mm-hmm.
This is still an undisclosed library. I mean, well,
undisclosed.
We're recording at the library.
Location.
We're recording at the library.
We're recording at the undisclosed library.
No, they don't know where we are. They're all gonna come.
They don't know
find
which library.
Us.
Right.
There's like 20 of them in this city.
You don't know nothing. You can't find us. No.
Right. It's still 7 leagues under the sea.
Yes. We took the Wonka Vader to get here.
Right. Like, you have to choose each library. Is it the one on in West Lafayette? East Lafayette?
Well, you're giving them too much info. The 90s
was the best time to be a kid, though. It really was.
Yeah.
It really was. I think the cell phone thing, I think kids with cell phones, it's not just the cell phones, though. It's just the, you know, the access.
Like
the cameras,
devices. Any kind of multimedia device. Right. You just, like, they've got a tablet or a cell phone or a computer, or all three.
Right. You can't, they're online too early, I think.
Yeah.
And a few of my friends have kids, you know, and some of my older friends have kids that are like, you know, like 11, 12, 13, and I'll see these kids on their phones and they're walking, and I'm like, you have no idea where you're going. You're just looking at your phone and walking. Like, how do you not fall on your face? Like, if I had something like that when I was 12, I don't even want to know how it ended.
I'm glad we didn't, because I was playing outside as a kid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know? And now, like, I imagine being a teacher nowadays, you know, because I remember it was like a big deal if your phone rang in class.
Oh, yeah.
And the teacher had to take it from you. It's impossible now.
Yeah, you couldn't do that.
It's a life support device at this point, you know.
But back to the question at hand. That was fun.
Right. That was fun.
That was a trip down memory lane.
Yeah, so.
We'll do that again later.
Put that on Way Back Wednesday. Throwback Thursday.
Right.
Whatever.
You guys have access to, like, so much stuff. Because when I was first starting out, I did not have easy access to the internet. Or to be able to just... PM a cosplayer and ask them how'd you make something, or can you help me with something like that, or go on YouTube and find a tutorial for exactly what I'm looking for. There was so much trial and error. Simplicity now makes patterns for
Zelda costumes. Yeah, like any kind of costume pattern. If you want,
you can talk to Yaya Han directly on Twitter.
Yeah. So I mean, but to even go in into Joanne's and pick up a pattern to make craft foam wings, to make Zelda, to make whatever it is I'm looking for, I never had that. You have great wig available to you. You have whatever you want, so you have no excuse.
Yeah, back then, we didn't know. I mean, a wig was a wig. Like, there was no, like, Kinecalon wig, Fivers, and, like, or there were. We just didn't know. We didn't have
everything came from Party City. Yeah.
Everything was Party City. Or Crystal Cottage, if you're in Lafayette.
And if somebody is being mean to you, they ain't met me yet. I'm a pretty mean person. Glenn thinks I'm nice.
I really do.
You should see me when people do bad things.
She starts to breathe fire like the dragon. Yeah.
There's
you don't want to cross it when she's angry.
I don't know. I've reached this point in my life where I just don't care anymore about other people. It doesn't matter if you're fat or skinny, big, small, whatever. I don't care. It doesn't bother me anymore because the only thing that matters is, do you like it?
Mm-hmm.
That's all I care about anymore.
Right.
I spent way too much time in my life worrying about other people.
Yeah. I mean, I think that's just a mark of the times when you're young.
You only care
about things that aren't important.
Out of all those people, I can only think of one of them who still talks to me right now. And she's been my friend for 13 years. Mm-hmm. So I can't think of any of those people that I let bother me that still think of me.
Right.
So what's the use in worrying about them? I'm just having fun. Mm-hmm. And I've been having fun for so long that it's finally paying off. Yeah. So if you have fun long enough, it'll probably pay off for you too.
Yeah.
Just keep having fun.
Yeah, just keep having fun. Yeah. Like, it might not make money at first, or it might not get you what you want to get at first, but it'll get you there if you keep liking it.
And you might never make money, because Bridget and I make, like, hardly nothing. We sell cosplay prints for $10 a piece. At our last event, we sold one.
Yay! But granted, that was a very small turnout, because it was up against
I'm just saying, in general.
Yeah, it was up against a music festival. Mm-hmm. We were at the film festival across the street. Yes. It was one of those, like, should have gone to the music festival.
It's not like we're pulling in, like, tons of money.
No. You know?
But, I mean, it was $10, so we got a burger. I mean, you know.
I mean, it does kind of, like, help out, too. I know whenever you were teaching at Joanne's, wasn't it partially because they knew, like, you make costumes?
Yes.
You know? So, I mean, it can kind of help with income.
But y'all have an opportunity to go to Japan.
Right.
Go to cosplay.
That's true.
That's a big deal. Well, man, like I said, I could talk to y'all for a long, long time, but I gotta wrap this up because because I'm being selfish. I have to edit this thing, and it's a monstrosity. I hate editing.
What do you use?
Something very cheap.
Okay.
Something very cheap.
I mean, that's fine. We can totally do this again.
It was cool though.
It is.
It was a lot of fun seeing y'all again. But I got one final segment to go to do. It's called 4-3-2-1. Four questions. 10 answers. But I'm going to make it special for y'all. I'm going to add a fifth one.
Okay.
And so it's going to be number 5, top 5 anime.
Ooh. Go. Wait, each of us answer separately?
Yeah.
Okay.
Top 5.
It's not the same.
X, 1999, Love Live. What else do I like? I like so many things.
Like, if you can only watch 5 for the rest of your life, what are those 5?
Better be a long one. Crap. Better put Naruto in there.
Good point. I hadn't thought of that. You're right. Some of them are short.
X-1999, Love Live, Sailor Moon. I just died. What are your 5 favorites?
My 5 favorites?
Go ahead, I'm still thinking.
I'm gonna go with what I can think of right now. Fushigi Yugi's always been one of my favorites. The mysterious play, whatever you want to call it.
Mm-hmm.
I love Mushishi. I love it. It's all supernaturally weird stuff. I really liked Code Geass a lot. I really liked
That's a good one.
I really liked Attack on Titan a lot too.
Really?
Oh, and I love Yu Yu Hakusho.
Oh, that's a good one.
Oh.
I love Yu Yu Hakusho definitely.
Yes.
I still can't, as bloody as it is, it still surprised me that it played on Cartoon Network,
right.
You know, like at the
right.
time it did.
Mm-hmm.
Of course it could have been edited, I don't remember.
I think so.
Did I reach five? Do I still have more?
I think that was four.
That's four?
I think so. Go again. Say them again.
Yu Yu. Yu Yu Hakusho, Mushishi, Code Geass, Attack on Titan.
Yes, got one more.
Got one more. No, I said
Fushigi. Okay.
Fushigi Yugi. Who is that?
I think I really have it this time. X-1999, because I love anything by Clamp. Sailor Moon, because everybody loves Sailor Moon, and all 200 episodes are finally on Hulu. Yay! So I could watch that for a while. Mm. I have like 80 hours left before I reach the end. Princess Tutu, because it looks cute and it's really not.
It's really weird.
It's the best! Love Life, because everyone loves idols! And I still have no idea what my fifth one is, but I'm sure it's probably something by Clamp. I got it.
You
it's it's Revolutionary Girl Utena, I think. Or currently by the same creator, Yurikuma Arashi.
Oh, that's right. Yurikuma Arashi.
The lesbian bears.
Lesbian bears. Show what I do.
Oh, wow.
Go.
Oh, wow.
I kind of want to switch out Attack on Titan.
Okay.
For Nana.
I forgot about that one.
Uh-oh.
No, I was going to say, you're going to hate it. Panty and stocking! Oh. I love me some panty and stocking!
Oh, wow.
Oh, God, it's so great and so raunchy.
I'm going to do...
She hates it.
I like Cowboy Bebop. It's short, but I love Cowboy Bebop.
No, that's good. Oh, and Outlaw Star. I love that one, too.
Outlaw Star might be number two for me. I didn't think of that one. Outlaw Star, number two. Yu Yu. Hakusho, number two.
Yeah, it's an amazing show.
I'm going to go with Naruto because it's long.
I love Naruto.
Yeah, I like that. And I like One Piece.
One Piece is awesome.
One Piece.
I haven't seen a lot of it.
I'm in One Piece, you know.
Yeah.
I am. I did some like bit parts in it. I went to Texas like on two different summers. I did bit parts. I know, we've reached time. I'm like, this is nothing.
Why did this come up earlier?
Episode 169 in the English dub. The one that I can actually remember what episode it is 169. There's Inaru, the guy with the earlobes, in Skypiea. His servant, she's an angel.
Oh,
she's an angel girl with a little thing on her head, a little bandana.
You were not in One Piece.
Asking her what the death count's going to be from something. And I'm like, oh, I wouldn't know anything about that, my lord. I'm just a humble servant girl or something. That's like my only line. But yeah, I'm in there.
Why didn't you say
it's
that?
It's a great one. Keep going with your aunt. Let's say anime.
That's like a whole nother.
That's another episode.
Minutes. Okay. Yeah,
that'll be on the next episode.
Yeah,
We're just giving you lots
of content.
Right.
Yeah. Give me
right.
something to write some more.
Yeah, dude, we're gonna do that next one. But yeah, I think I did five. One Piece, Naruto, Cowboy Bebop,
Yu Yu Hakusho,
Yu Yu, and Outlaw.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Same question, four albums. Four albums. Yeah, for the rest of your life.
You want to go first or me first?
You know what's funny? Young people that I have on the show, they can never give me albums. They can only give me artists. Because they don't say albums anymore. Damn kids.
Okay, I'm going to go with Mastodon's Once More Around the Sun. It came out in like 2014.
Okay.
No. Yeah, 2014. Like, in my opinion, best album that came out in 2014. One of the best metal albums ever. Typo Negative's October Rust. I don't remember what year that was. It was in the 90s, I guess. That was really good. You said five albums?
Four.
Four albums.
Yeah.
halfway through. Let's see. Goodness gracious. That's a toughie. What else am I listening to these days? No, of all time.
Yeah.
Right. The Cure, Disintegration.
Okay. That's three.
That's three.
It's always the hard one.
One more.
Last one's always hardest.
One more. Trying to think.
The Doobie Brothers.
No. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love me some Doobie Brothers, but no, let's forget about that for a second. Why don't you name some, and then I'll come up with my last one.
Okay. Amber Lynn's Blueprints for the Black Market. Amber Lynn's Vital. There's lots of Amber Lynn. I just listen to Amber Lynn forever. Yeah. Mayday Parade's A Lesson in Romantics.
For the Mayday Parade. I knew that was next.
I also love lots of Mayday Parade. And then when I get tired of being emo.
Oh gosh, it's so much work being emo. Let's stop for a second.
But the last one was going to be another emo one, so I'm trying to think of something that's not emo.
I just thought of my last one. Okay, go ahead. Okay, Metallica's Master of Puppets.
Awesome.
There we go.
Cool.
Your turn.
Last one.
Last non-emo one. I guess I'll just pop right back into the 80s and let's go with Bryan Adams' Waking Up the Neighbors.
Awesome. Sweet. I already did mine on previous episodes, and we're running out of time. We are way past time.
Of course we are.
Top three cartoons that aren't anime. Because usually the anime one is especially for y'all, but top three cartoons that aren't anime.
Beetlejuice cartoon. I don't even know why. I just loved it when I was a kid. It's probably terrible now if I rewatched it, but I don't care. I'm still going to say it because it's Beetlejuice and he's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Non-anime cartoons. Gosh, I forgot what those are like.
I did.
I like the Venture Brothers a lot. Brothers are awesome. Oh, Metalocalypse.
That's great
too. Oh my god, actually, yeah. And I totally listen to Death Clock in my car.
The last two you said, they're starting to not be episodic, and they're starting to like really have story arcs and stuff like that, which is dope.
Yeah, that is pretty cool.
That's your three?
That was three. Yeah, there we go.
I can't lie. I don't watch non-anime cartoons. But back in the day, I really enjoyed The Legend of Zelda, which was not an anime.
Mm-hmm. If you go back and rewatch it, it's just like Beetlejuice, I bet. It's going to be terrible.
Actually, I do own it, and it is terrible. Okay. But I still like it.
I love The Legend of Zelda, so.
Right, so there was that. And like She-Ra and He-Man, I really liked those. So
I have a She-Ra costume from when I was.
So I'm sure I'd still appreciate some content of that, but I don't really watch anything that's not anime anymore.
Mm-hmm. Okay, cool.
I'm a bad person.
No, that's fair.
I'm not really into Family Guy and stuff like that.
Right. Okay. Yeah. I can dig it. That's cool.
I'm always into The Simpsons though, so we'll go with that.
And it's long.
Right, and it's forever.
It is long.
And Futurama.
Futurama's dope. What is my number two? Two celebrities of the opposite sex that y'all would spend a weekend with.
Of the opposite sex?
Yeah.
Johnny Depp?
That's what I was going to say.
Not just because he's an amazing actor, but he's also
hot.
A rock star. Oh, and he's hot. And he's a rock star. Yeah. He's in the Vampires of whatever you call Hollywood. I want to see them one day.
They was on the Grammys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I couldn't think of the band name for some reason. Vampires, Johnny Depp. And another one. You want to use that as one too? We'll both go with Johnny Depp.
Well, I mean, that's what I was gonna say actually. So,
You do one, and then I'll think of another one too. You said two.
Gactyl. I love Gactyl.
Who's that?
He's a Japanese rock star.
Okay.
But he is also a vampire because he's only in his 30s, but he definitely doesn't look it, and he claims to be like 400 years old. Like, literally.
He's in his 30s, but he looks older or he looks younger?
He looks younger.
Okay.
But he claims to be a vampire and to be like 400 years old.
He might be.
He's super, super amazing with like his music and his videos and stuff like that. And I love everything he does.
That's cool. So,
I wouldn't even listen to Japanese music if I had no idea who he was. What about you?
Oh, yeah. That's another cool one for me. I've gotten to see both of these, I've gotten to see these people on stage before, but it would be kind of a tie between, I wanted to meet Robert Smith from The Cure, but they don't really do meet and greets from what I understand.
Okay.
But I mean, I saw him at Voodoo Fest, like however many years ago.
But this is if you could.
If I could meet him, like, personally sit down, like,
week.
for a weekend.
Yeah, that's what it, yeah, so spend a weekend. I don't count Voodoo Fest, in other words.
Right.
Yeah.
Then
so.
It'd be him?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
All right, cool, cool. And y'all already answered the last question. Well, one place on planet Earth that you haven't been that you want to go?
Japan.
That is unanimous right here. That is unanimous. Well, that's the AquaMethod Podcast, y'all. I really appreciate y'all rocking with me.
No problem.
This extra long. This is the longest episode. Because this is 1:16 right now, and I got 12 minutes recorded previously. So yeah. But before y'all go, give out y'all social media one more time.
Oh yeah.
It's Cute Classy Chaos on Facebook. C3 Cosplay on Twitter. Michelle is Sanctuary Memory on Instagram.
And I am Miss Ooh La La on Instagram.
That is M-I-S-S-M-S.
Oh, M-I-S-S. I think there's an underscore. And then O-O-L-A-L-A. Let me actually, you want me to, I can check.
Yeah, check okay. it out.
You can edit this whole, like, searching through my phone thing, okay. like, out if you want. I just want to, I mean, when I log
you know
in,
what?
I don't really.
You know what? Just write it. I'm going to get y'all to write it down anyway. Uh-oh. Those beats are very bad. I think I'm feeling finished. This one's done.
Oh.
But yeah, so it's not recording on me anymore. But that's okay.
Miss underscore O-O-L-A-L-A. Yeah.
Okay, cool. And as always, y'all, you can follow me on Twitter, Grasshopper GP, Instagram, Grasshopper GP. Check me out. Send me an email, grasshoppergp@yahoo.com. Any types of sponsorships, advertisements, or you just have something nice to say about the podcast, I really appreciate it. Once again, thank y'all for all the listens and the views. I really appreciate it. Thank y'all very, very much. You are listening to this on Grasshopper GP Official. That's Grasshopper with 3 S's because when I made the account, I couldn't spell. Grasshopper GP Official, 3 S's is the YouTube account. It's your boy GP, Miss Bridget, Miss Michelle. Y'all be good.